Hello, 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 friends and neighbors. Welcome back. It's me, Kick to the Head. We are on Farming Simulator 2013, and this doesn't look like the old family farm. That's because we are in France. Yes, we are in France. This is a beautiful little detailed mod that brings the south of France to us. It's got a slew of options with it as well. It's a very, very nice detailed map. I'll try to run through it all with you. As you can see, it's definitely darker than normal, and that's because of the lighting effect that's employed in here by the Dark Night mod. So let me just read through this, what we got here. It features 3 farms, 40 cultivated fields, 3 agricultural cooperatives, a store, a concession, a slaughterhouse, a lime carrier, a BGA, and it does have the BGA mod extension, 12 possible groups of crops, wheat, barley, canola, oats, sugar beet, potatoes, sorghum, which is a type of grass that is used to make different types of products and stuff with sort of like wheat and stuff from my understanding from the wiki. Also has lucerne, clee, and grass. Now, I'm not sure what the lucerne and clee is, but we'll get into that, I'm sure. The types of animals that are available on the map is cow, sheep, chicken, pork, beef. There's another type there that I can't quite read what it is. Eggs, pig, and cattle. The soil mod is installed. The dark night mod is installed. The morning fog mod is installed. And the building forest mod is installed. So the map author installed all the latest gizmos in with this, including, like I said, the soil mod, the forest mod, dark night, and so on. If we step out here, it looks like to be a slight traffic jam out here. Not sure what's going on out here, but yeah, looks like we do have a traffic jam. Now, we'll just take a quick run around the farm. You can see what everything looks like. It definitely looks like the south of France. Beautiful little country here. We just take a quick look up onto the bridge over here, and we look down into the brook. Beautiful little area down in there. You can see his little farms and little houses dotting the countryside. And hello. And you can see little churches and buildings. It's got a lot of character to it. But we'll get into it all. I've only been into a couple places, so we'll explore the map together. Now down here, of course, we have our manure spreader, our trailer, our cultivator, plow. Looks like we got ourselves a little conveyor belt as well. Whether this is movable or not, I am not sure. But it looks like it might be. Looks like we can maneuver that around with the tractor, maybe. Not sure what these are. Maybe the spare bits and parts and stuff. We got some pallets we can jump up on. Potato boxes, it looks like. We can see we got the chicken farm here. And you can see they do need wheat and water from here. Now, that way, I'm not sure. Looks like we just fill up with water here. It's a water point. Yes, it's just a water point here. Beautiful little area right behind our farm here. Here will most likely be the cows, because I don't see no sheep place for wool. So it looks like this will probably be the cow or beef cattle. If we just quickly look at the map, we are somewhere right in here. And unfortunately, I can't see everything. And we only own one field, and it appears to be a type of grass out here. So I'm not sure why we only own one field, but we'll get into that. You can see farm one, our Ferme. And why I'm getting you on here, the map is called Le Ferme Limousine, from what I can pronounce. It is in French, so if I butchered that, my apologies. But we do own one field right here at the main farm. And you can see there are a lot of fields that we do have on the map. So farm one is here, farm two, if we go back, farm two is up here, and farm three, I'm assuming this is farm three. I'm not sure what the Haute-Vienne is, and I don't actually see that on the map anywhere unless it's under here as well. But you can see it's highly detailed and very, very big, but we'll get into everything as we go along. Now, what's that? That looks like all types of grains. Most likely, you just come up underneath it. And these doors do open by themselves as soon as you get close to them. We've got a windrower in there. We've got, well, that's probably the, that's the windrower and that's the tedder, or vice versa. That's the windrower and that's the tedder out there. Got some motor oil. What do we got in here? It looks to be the fuel. Over here is just another storage area. We do have a cedar, fertilizer, and stuff over here. Cedar's out there, the fertilizer's in there. So that looks to be pretty much the main farm. And what I've done is just moved the starting vehicles up here. And as you can see, you got this little Lamborghini here, this little geotrack here, and then the bell trailer. Now these starting vehicles are way slow, and I don't like these bell trailers anyway. So what I'm going to do is, we only have, let me just open this up. It only started this with just under 12,000. Now that's not really a lot to do anything. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to sell our starting vehicles here, as well as the bell trailer. We should be able then to pick up the Unimog Forest Edition, and that acts as a tractor as well. We'll be able to use that. Pick up another cheaper bell trailer, and so on and so forth. Now down here, this must be the town. Make sure no cars are coming. Not sure. Is this the sawmill maybe in here? What do we got in here? Looks like got a rough bit of road here. Yep. Rough bit of road. Now this looks like the town proper. You can see everything is in French. You've got some nice terrain out here and stuff. Looks like the gas station there. Maybe some houses in here. Is this a, maybe a store or something around the corner here? Doesn't say. No sell point or tipping point. Got a nice church. Got a post office over there. And town continues to go on. But let's go back over here to where we want to sell the tractors and stuff. Now, unfortunately, the shop has business hours, so we can't go there anytime we want. Let's just get out of the way of that car coming behind us. So if we quickly look over here, you'll see the hours of operation is from 7:30 to 12, and then they close for a couple hours for lunch, and then they open up again at 1400 till 1730. So you have very limited time that you can actually purchase items and move them out of there, which makes sense. That's like that in real life. Whoa, boy, he took that a little fast. How you doing? Slow down. Thank you. What an idiot. Let's go ahead and move this, bring it back in. You ain't gonna let me move it, are you? I'm gonna have to reset that. Try to pop that out. Nope. So let's just quickly reset that trailer, and I will have to go back and pick it up. So let me pull this back out of the way. Of course, that milk truck there now is going to be stuck until we go away. So let's just go to another tractor with us. I've only got one more tractor, and that's this front end loader here. Now we got to find out where they reset the, we do have a little harvester in there, but we need to find out where they reset the bell trailer. If we look here, we were right here, and the bell trailer got reset up here somewhere, I thought. Let's see if we can quickly find it. It's not going to be in here, I know. I would have thought it was right around here somewhere. Cross the way over here, maybe? I don't know what's over here. Let me get rid of this for a minute. This. Oh, it's up there. It looks like it reset it inside the actual store. Did it reset it in there? Truck's gone. Can we get in there? Let's see. Let's move this a little closer. Did it reset it in here somewhere? Yes, it did. It reset it back here in the equipment storage area. Of course, we can't get in there either. So it looks like where you buy equipment, it stores it in its own little lot out there, which is pretty nice. And then around back here, it looks like where we sell. So I can see a potential problem, though. If you do reset something, if you have to reset something for whatever reason, you better hope that the shop is open. Otherwise, you're going to get stuck and you ain't going to be able to get it out of there. You're not going to be able to get it out of there. Okay, so let's continue on then. Let's go back to our front end loader. So we're back down on the main farm down here. And I don't see where all the animals are. Let's go see if we can find our field. Field 15 is right over between there and there. So if we go continue, it's going to be over that way somewhere. Field 15. Let's put on a PDA so we can see it. Let me get back through all that. And hit 9. So field 15 is right up the road. So let's go take a look at that. Hopefully by that time then, okay, you can see on the farm we do have the cattle, and it looks like the sheep all right here, and then the chicken as well, all fairly close. So we'll be able to look into all that once it gets going. There's a lot of tipping points on the map, you can see. And then field 15 should be this first turnoff right up here. That should be field 15 right here, and it does look like it's a grass field. Okay, doesn't open automatically this one, so O. And it looks like you have to be out of the vehicle to actually open it. There it goes. Wow, that is super slow. You actually have to stay close to it to open it. Wow. Okay, so it's open now. There goes that truck. I have a feeling that milk truck's going to be like Land of Italy, always on the road. So, field 15. That looks like field 15 is up there. So if we open this, can we now close this as well? No. We have to get out of the tractor, but... So this is field 15 here. So I'm assuming this is grass. But you know what they say when you assume. And we do have a mower back out at the farm, so we'll be able to get that in a second. Matter of fact, we do have little time to go till 7:30. You know what? Let's take a tour around the map. That's what this first episode will be. Let's take a quick tour around the map. We won't get into any actual farming. We'll do just see where everything is. It's going to be a little difficult. So what I'll do is, looks like we could have come out through the backside of our farm maybe. Let's just back out through here. There we go. Get back inside. No, stay outside. That way you guys can see the beautiful countryside, what we have, and see the sights. So this is France. Like I said, it is really nice. I really like this. It kind of reminds me of some of the places I used to live in Arkansas and stuff. The way the hills are and the way the greenery and everything is. It reminds me a lot of Arkansas. But this is France, like I said. So we have tipping points here. Not sure what that is yet. We'll have to wait till things open to go in there. And it looks like some kind of mill or something back here. Let's see if we take a quick turn around. We can get fuel here. And again, hours of operation. This is from 8 to 12:30 and 14:30 to 18:30. And this looks like the garden center or something along those lines. Wow, everything's got to be opened. So this will definitely be a test of time management. You're going to have to test time manage all your fields and stuff to be able to do your sales and purchases and stuff at opening hour times and stuff. So what do we got out back here? Another section of road. Okay, now we got a tipping point down to the right. To the left, it goes up. Let's see what's down the right. This is gorgeous. I really love the detail on this map. And what do we have down here? This looks to be quite a big parking area for sure. Now, it is dark, like I said, but as it gets lighter in the daylight, as the sun rises higher, then everything lightened becomes more light, or more lit, rather. This looks like maybe a slaughterhouse or something along those lines, maybe, where you bring animals out here for slaughter, I'm assuming. What does it say over here? A little blurry, a little low res. Yeah, this looks to be like a slaughterhouse or something here. And right down the road we have some more sell points. What's down here? Make sure nothing's coming. And then some more sell points here. This is Natia. Maybe this is the one of the co-op things. Actually, that looks like wood and stuff in there. This might actually be the sawmill. Can we get in there? No. What about over here? This is the entrance actually here. And 8 to 4:30, yada, yada, yada. Same as always. Agricultural. Natia Agricultural. Is this... kind of looks like a sawmill. No, or yes. Is that wood chips? Or is that something else? Manure maybe in here? I don't know. I can't tell what that is. Maybe you just bring different types of seeds and, or not seeds, but like grains and earth fruits and stuff here maybe? All this, I hope, will become clear as time progresses. Not sure what all this is. Can we get out now? Can we go through here? Yes. Okay, so, and then we got stuff on the other side of the map. So I think what I'm going to do, let's see, we're 20 minutes in. I think what we'll do is we're going to leave it there. I am going to start a series on this. This is going to be a mini-series to help fill out our Farming Simulator 2013 Old Family Farm and until the 2 weeks release of Farming Sim 15. This will just be, like I said, a mini-series. I know a couple of the other mini-series that we started fell due to problems with the individual maps that we had, but this map, I don't know, this map seems like it has a lot more work done on it, and I haven't had any issues with it yet, but I'm going to play around with it and do some work on it and see how things go. And then I think, well, like I said, we'll do a mini-series on it. So if this is a map that you'd like to see a mini-series on, let me know. I won't start it unless it's something you guys would like to see, whether you guys like the map or not. So... if you like it, mash the like up button. That will help determine whether I should start a series on this or not. Also, leave your comments and suggestions below. As always, I do reply to them all. And we'll just take a quick trip out here to the biogas. So this is the biogas out here. Ooh. And this supposedly has the biogas extension mod on it. Now, I'm not sure where you would go for that. Yep, it sure does. You can tell right there. Increased plant size, decreased plant size. And you need 240,000 required for startup. So it does have the BGA mod extension as well. So like I said, I'm looking forward to this map. If you are too, let me know in the comments below and the like up button. Until next time, I'm a kick to the head. This is Farming Simulator 2013 on the Le Ferme Limousine. Talk to you all later. Have a great day. Bye-bye.